Well, hi guys, I'm Celestial Shadows, and today we're playing the Hourglass of Lepidoptera, our chronicle. At least I think that's how you say that. Anyways, it came out today on Steam, and it looks like a good game. So, let's start. Dark, cold, and empty world. In it, a butterfly flies silently and elegantly, wrapping itself with flowing bluish-white dust. A butterfly? Why is it here? I try to reach for the butterfly, as if I'm being pulled towards it. And let me check one more thing. Yep, everything's on. Resume game. The butterfly was so close, but something soft stopped me. Something very soft, warm, and comfortable to touch. It won't let me reach for the butterfly. The butterfly flies away into the emptiness, as if it was laughing at my vain attempt. Huh? What's this? Warm. Very soft. Something that fits in my hand. Soft, warm, and well-rounded. Hey! Stop! Stop that! What? A sultry voice wakes up my consciousness in a flash. That's enough! Get your hand off! The first thing I see is a girl wearing a nun's habit. She's looking at me with a smile. I can't say a word. I'm so charmed by her bright blonde hair. The blonde girl is smiling, but I feel some sort of murderous rage radiating from her. Wait, have I done something really, really bad? My heart begins to beat unusually hard. My instincts and not experience tell me you're facing certain death.
Are you
done with your prayers? Do you have any last words to say? I don't know if it's because I'm so shaken up, but I have to move my fingers to confirm what I am touching and how it feels. Quite a breast you've got. It's okay to punch you, I think. You touched a girl's precious part, so I'm sure it's okay, right? The blonde girl keeps smiling, raising her right hand. Hey, wait! I shut my eyes in apprehension. A loud noise goes off by my ear. There's no pain. Why? Surprised? You tricked me. Alright, I was scared for nothing. Hey! You don't seem to be reflecting on what you did. In that case... Damn, this time she's serious. No. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Wazato janai mitai dashi. 今回はなかったことにしてあげるけど。
Well, I know it wasn't on purpose, so I'll forgive you this time, but...
次やったらどうなるか。わかるよね?
If you do it again, you know what's going to happen, right?
はい。二度といたしません。
Okay, I won't ever do it again. Wait, why am I apologizing like this? I've never done that to anyone, even to my family. Not even once in my life.What the hell is going on around here? I look around to get a hold of the situation I'm in. Some ceiling of a dull color, unfamiliar Western furniture, an uncomfortable bed, and the most important thing, an unknown blonde girl in front of me. With all this, I conclude, Good night.Okay, good night. Hey, what are you doing?
だってこれは夢だろ。本当の俺は自室のベッドで眠っているはずだから。
This is a dream, isn't it? My real self should be sleeping in my room, so... Yes, I'm sure that I fell asleep while reading a novel I ordered from Germany yesterday. I'm so hooked on that novel that I'm having a dream about a scene from it. But I'm not sure it had a cute blonde girl. And the musty smell from the sheets is a strange...So strangely realistic. Well, whatever.
こんなマイペースな子、初めてだわ。
I've never seen such a laid-back boy before.
これは夢でもなんでもないんだから、ちゃんと起きて。
This is not a dream or anything, so get up!Five more minutes.
もう深く眠り込んじゃってる。こんな状況ですぐに眠れるって、なんて神経がずぶといのかしら。
He's in a deep sleep already? He's so bold to have a quick nap in this situation. She checks me harder, trying to wake me up.Quit it. Lack of sleep is bad for the skin. And he doesn't wake up, so...
これはウィンスレット式108の目覚まし術の奥義を使わないとダメかしら?
I should use the secrets of Winslet's 108 awakening techniques, shouldn't I?Wait, skipping to secret techniques already? There's 108 of them? Jeez, I have so many questions about that.
まあ、よく知らない子だけど、大丈夫でしょ。
I don't know him well, but it's alright. The girl's slender arms reach around my body. So far, I've had servants try many different methods to wake me up. Let's see how she fares. Tickle, tickle, tickle!Fingers tickle me, hitting weak spots precisely. Hey, if you don't wake up soon, I'll tickle you more like this. Might be a glitch, hello. No, okay, I understood. I'll wake up. I'm waking up.And probably everything doesn't have voice acting, hello. Are you awake now? Yeah, thanks. She tickled me for 3 minutes. Because of that, I'm breathing unsteadily, but my consciousness is much clearer than before. With my head clear, I carefully look around once again. She's so rough, he hurt my butt. Old Western furniture. And a blonde girl in a nun's habit.Nothing's changed at all. Now, I have to introduce myself. I am Rosary Winslet. I'm a nun of this church. Thought this was a church. Turns out I was right. From her clothes and name, Rosary, it makes sense. But, hey Rosary, why am I sleeping in this musty old church? Musty old? Well, that's not totally wrong, but I want things cleared up. I was reading a book at home and fell asleep. How did I wake up in a church like this? I don't know. When I was out on a walk at night, I saw you passed out. So I brought you here. Passed out? Where did you find me? On the streets of the slums. You were sleeping like a log there. I was so worried about you. Slums? Why was I there? After the war, not everybody earned their piece of happiness. The slums are where people who have lost their homes or family gathered.
I don't know why, but if you were left out there, you might have lost the chance to see another day.
Rosary's right. If I was left lying in the slums, I might have been killed. No doubt about that. Everybody does their best to stay alive in the slums. Their own lives come first, even if it'll cost others' lives. I've learned this from books. I've never been to the slums, ever. I was asleep so carelessly in the slums, I can't believe it. With so many unbelievable things happening, I lost control in spite of myself.
Come down! Well, first of all, may I ask you who you are?
I am Tadayoshi Kurokawa, likely successor of Kurokawa Zaibatsu.
Tadayoshi Kurokawa? You? Seriously?
Rosary's big eyes open wider, and she stares at me as if seeing a ghost.
Huh? Why should I make something like that up? But Tadayoshi Kurokawa.
After those words, Rosary rushes out of the room.
Huh?
And she runs back into the room.
Look at this!
A newspaper? Rosary hands me a newspaper, a concerned look on her face. Tadayoshi Kurokawa, scion of Kurokawa Zaibatsu, dies of a heart attack. Unlike small obituaries, it's a major article telling how serious the situation is. Kurokawa Zaibatsu is that influential over the public. Hey, Rosary, what kind of joke is this?
Do you really think it's a joke?
Rosary didn't know that I'm Tadayoshi Kurokawa until I told her. And I can't think of a good reason for her to pull a nasty prank like this.
As it says in the newspaper, the day before yesterday, Tadayoshi Kurokawa passed away from a heart attack. And today, his funeral will be held at the Kurokawa Mansion.
Huh? I'm dead and my funeral is today? I don't get it. Anyway, I've got to go back to my mansion. I didn't know I was dead, but nobody would believe such a ridiculous story. But there's no point in staying here. I have to return to my mansion and see the truth for myself.
To your mansion? Do you even know the way to the Kurokawa Mansion from here?
That's true. I've never been to the slums. And I rarely go out of the mansion in the first place. Just staying in to read books. Then Rosary, prepare a car as soon as you can.
Huh? I don't think I can get you a car.
What? Cars are everywhere. There are plenty around.
Huh. As you said before, this place is an old rusty church in the slums. You know that, right? Cars are too expensive for poor people like us. So there's not a chance we would have one.
Telephones it in. Make a call to the Kurokawa family to bring someone here.
Unlike string phones that children use as toys, telephones aren't a thing people in the slums can easily have. And even if we had one, do you think the Kurokawa family occupied with your funeral will speak with you? Then, so, what should I do? I had a life in which I could get whatever I wanted. Cars were everywhere. Each room had a telephone. Well-tailored clothes, lots of books. None of that existed here. Rosary scans me from head to toe, thinking about something. Since it never even occurred to you to walk home from here, you're definitely a son of a noble family. Your clothes look nice and expensive. And your eyes don't look like you're lying.
So you believe that I am Tadayoshi Kurokawa?
If you call yourself Tadayoshi Kurokawa, then you're him.
Thanks, Rosary. Now tell me how to get to my mansion. If walking is the only option, I'll take it.
Tell me how? Are you really going there by yourself?
Yeah. Things won't change if I stay here. And I have to return to the mansion and see what's going on. Rosary is not my servant or anything. It's not her responsibility to take care of me. So I can't rely on her that easily.
Hey, if a rich-looking boy like you goes walking on the street, it'll be like you're asking to get jumped.
But I can't just stay here. Tell me, quickly.
How are you again? Are all the Kurokawas like that? Okay, I'll take you to the Kurokawa mansion.
Really?
Yes. If I leave you to your own devices, you'll really be going out alone, and it's some kind of fate that I found you in the slums, so I'll stay with you to the end. Also, I'm a nun, so it's my rightful duty to help troubled souls.
A rightful duty to help troubled souls. Servants in the mansion had a duty to take care of me, but that's because I'm Tadayoshi Kurokawa. Helping without an ulterior motive? I've never seen something like that.
If we leave the church now, we should arrive at the mansion before noon.
Okay, now, please. Still sitting on the bed, I swing my legs over.
What are you doing?
Huh? I wanted you to put my shoes on.
I should start by teaching you to put on your own shoes.
Rosary looks a little astonished, but she also looks happy somehow. Sorry, I'll put on the shoes myself.
Oh? I was sure you'd complain about that. It's surprisingly straightforward of you to apologize.
I'm honest, you know. I always have been.
This should go herein.
This is the first time I put on my own shoes. Try to mimic what my servants always did to me. Oh, shoes are so easy to wear. How come I haven't done such a simple task by myself? It feels quite good, doing something that I haven't even tried before. What a discovery!
Well done! Good boy!
Rosary smiles and pats my head. Hey, don't treat me like a child! I complain, but I don't feel so bad for being treated like that. Actually, it feels good. Come to think of it, I never had anyone pat my head before. I've experienced many things in a very short time. Things that I've never had before. Feels like my world is growing and expanding.
Now is a good time to go.
Yeah. Show me the way, Rosary.
Try to keep up with me, Tadayoshi-kun.
I don't know when it happened, but she started calling me Tadayoshi-kun. It appears she's respected me a bit more. I'm pleased about that. But there's no time to be delighted. I, Tadayoshi Kurokawa, have died of a heart attack. My funeral is being held. I must get to the bottom of this ridiculous situation as fast as I can. What's this? It's so cool. I learned of the slums through books and pictures. The scenery is almost identical to the pictures I've seen, but it seems so different in person.
Hey, I understand that you're in high spirits, but stop wandering around.
I know, but everything that I've seen, Phil, is unknown to me. I'm getting excited with all these new sensations. Hey, Rosary? Is that barking thing a dog?
A stray dog. It'll be seriously bad if it bites you, so you better stay away from it.
What? Stray dog? I quickly try to hide behind Rosary as I remember something.
Hmm? What's wrong to do, Shikan? Say, you afraid of stray dogs?
Rosary, aren't you afraid? It's that stray dog! If it bites you, you will die, you know? Another thing I read once. Untamed dogs usually carry viruses. If one bites you, the virus will enter your body, resulting in death.
That can happen sometimes. But that one looks fine, because it's not scared of water.
Scared of water? The dog was barking at me first, but I noticed that now it's playing in a fountain nearby.
I don't know the details, but I was told to be careful with dogs that fear water, because they could have rabies.
Oh, I see. Is that some sort of survival knowledge from a local resident? Seems like there are still many things I don't know about.
Well, it's still not good if it bites you, so we'd better get out of here.
Yeah, it would be painful. Rosary walks past the dog as if it's not a threat.
Don't follow me, please.
I beg the dog silently and resume walking, staying close to Rosary.
Teruyoshi-kun, the place ahead is more unsafe compared to the other parts of the slums, so don't wander away from me.
Oh, Teruyoshi-kun? Where did you go?
You're too fast. Wait for me.
I've been walking for an hour.
My legs hurt so much, and I'm out of breath.
In contrast, Rosary's still walking. She's far ahead of me.
Hey, I need a break.
I complain, but I'm pushing my weary self to walk, so as not to lose sight of Rosary. Is this the center of the slums or something? I see more and more people around.
Hey boy, you wanna have some good fun with me?
Huh?
Who are you?
Most of the people in the slums were looking at me, as if they were evaluating my worth. One of them, a woman, is talking to me. I'm curious, what fun are you talking about? But I'm in a hurry. Ask someone else, okay?
You're a naive boy, aren't you?
From your nice appearance, I'm guessing you're a noble son who lost his way? The woman clings to me persistently. Jeez, I've got no time for such things. Hey, you! Quit bothering him. He looks uncomfortable. Now, you pretty looking boy. How about an iced tea at my house? Wow. I don't know, but I think I'll lose something important if I go with him. Now I'm in a mess. I'm losing Rosary while they're nagging me.
Hey! What's your business with my friend?
Rosary. I thought I lost her, but it appears Rosary came back for me.
Damn, a nun. So he's an orphan. Ain't worth the trouble.
He's
She's with a girl? Whatever then. When Rosary arrives, the people leave grumbling. Impressive, she's a reliable nut.
Tadayoshi-kun, this place has more dangerous people than any part of the slums. Stay with me, alright?
But Rosary, you left me behind because you walk so fast, didn't you?
I didn't expect you to be so weak since you're a boy.
Yeah. But you're way better than me. Girls are supposed to be delicate and have to be protected by men, I thought. In many foreign stories, the men save the women. There's a story of a plumber with a nice mustache saving the princess from a fire-breathing beast in every chapter. Sounds like Mario. That's a story for another time.
Tadayoshi-kun!
And she caused an earthquake. Rosary's face turns red in anger. She looks dreadful despite her smiling.
Are you implying that I'm not very girlish?
No, I didn't. Yeah, didn't mean that at all.
I'm a girl, dreaming of meeting my prince someday.
But in Rosary's case, I think she'll be keeping her prince on a leash.
What did you say? I want to hear.
Rosary, you frighten me so much. Do my thoughts show up that obviously on my face?
I'm sorry.
I just apologized to her.
It's too late.
With puffed cheeks, she starts to walk away.
I beg your pardon. Don't leave me, please. Please?
I follow Rosary in a hurry. Today's lesson. Do not ever make Rosary mad.
Hey, how long do we have to walk? Well, about an hour, I think. If we took too much time, your funeral would be over. We have to hurry.
Eek! Seriously? I'm pushing myself so hard just to walk, but Rosary's still looking fine. Isn't this something like a woman's mind is a other vein? 1 hour later, I realize Rosary is no longer mad at me.
Even the children in the church can walk this far without breaking a sweat. Keep it up!
I recall seeing a bunch of noisy kids when I left the church. It seems Rosary doesn't live in that old church by herself.
Yeah, I can't be losing to those kids.
I lost count of my steps by now, but I keep forcing my tired body to pick up the pace. I've got a feeling that harsher challenges are going to appear, ones that I've never experienced before. I can't let them beat me here.
His eyes were so dull a while ago. Trying hard not to lose, yes? That's the spirit for a boy!
She passed my head while saying this. I want you to stop treating me like a kid. That was weird when I cut it off. Oh well.
What? What?
I was about to retort to Rosary, but a child's cry interrupted me.
Oh, you fell over? It hurts! It hurts!
Oh well. I tried. Is that a nun's nature? As soon as I hear a child crying, Rosary's already going to him.
It's not bleeding much, so you should be okay.
Rosary smiles at him, holding her clean-looking handkerchief against a wound.
I'll kiss it to make it better. Now the pain's gone. You're a good boy. You'll be okay, understand? Yes. Thanks, lady.
After Rosary consoles him, the child stops crying and runs off. I wanted her to stop treating me like a child. But I think that crying child and I are the same to her.
Rosary,
I think you'll become a good mother.
Mother?
Hmm? For a moment, I see a deep sadness on her face.
Now, we're almost there. We've got to hurry or we won't make it. but it disappears the next second. She starts walking again, her demeanor restored. Yeah, we must hurry!
And someone else.
Isn't that Rosary? And that boy with her. Isn't familiar to me. Who is he? Oh well, it's nothing to do with me.
And Rosary.